Hey everybody, Dr. Cranky here in the Lab-RAT-ory. It's bath time for the super bad big bird. I am making a video here to walk you through the process between coats and also between clear coats that we use for getting a miles deep, smooth, shiny finish on our model. And we're using the super bad big bird. We have in this plastic bag, we have our trustworthy sanding and polishing pads or cloths, and you know, they're pretty well used. You know, you can keep these for a long time, even though they lose some of their grit along the way, but that's okay. We have 2400, we have two 2400s because this is from two sets that I used to have, and normally this is just a quick little thing that I do, which is I double up on the 2400, then I move on to let's see, 3200, 4000 is the normal grit we begin with, we like to begin with, especially if the body is pretty smooth. 6000, 8000, and then 12000. All right, and that's it. I hear you can go higher, but for me that's overkill, and that's pretty much it. So we're beginning here, in essence we're beginning with 4000. We're putting away the others. All right, so 4000 right here. Okay, and oh, you're saying to yourself, but wait, you haven't shown us the actual super bad big bird finish with clear on it. Not only is it clear, but it has two coats of clear effects bling in there, which of course you can't see, but you could probably see it in the sunlight. And there it is, my friends. That's the super bad big bird with two coats of clear effects and two coats of DuPont spot acrylic clear. And we just love the way it turned out. Now, I'm not going to do the body because that'll take forever and ever and ever. What we have here is a pot with a little warm soapy water, okay? And so we just come here and gently you start, you know, going over the entire surface, shiny surface. Now, normally when you begin with 2400, which I don't like to do, I do it if it's really rough, but the process I use of buffing and sanding every step of the way guarantees that you really never have to start with 2400. I begin this process with 4000, which kind of guarantees that I'm not going to cut down to the paint, to the base coat, to the primer. That's not gonna happen with 4000. So you just make sure you keep everything, you know, wet and smooth and slick with the soap, and make sure that you do every single nook and cranny, every surface. I hear some people say that they just like to go in one direction. You know, I don't. I go in however many directions, you know, so I change it up a little bit. So, you know, you check the part periodically by dipping it in the water. And now the thing with this clear that I love is that it really bites down hard on the paint and really shrinks everything back down. I mean, this is so thin. So what you want to do is you want to feel with your fingertips, make sure that none of that tape, none of those tape marks are coming through. All right, now we just finished 4000. Now we are going to do 6,000, and it's already almost 5 minutes. This might end up being a two-parter, my friends. Okay, so, but you know, I mean, it's there's no exact science to this, other than you have to be careful. You do not do it too hard. Okay, now, you know, I think a good way to practice this is
to the Cranky Show.